Oh.
Okay, it's about that time of the day. You know what? It's gotta be.
What has it gotta be?
Well, I have to say, though, today's one was better than yesterday's.
Oh, thank you.
You're improving. Keep
yesterday,
doing
I thought
it.
Of it. I was again, like, how about baby like your food? I was saying, it's gotta be.
Well, you know, I don't even do that.
Please, you do.
Oh, you know what time it's gotta be. You'll not bite your hand.
Yeah.
You know, ladies. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh.
And look at you. Unconsciously, we all put our chest out. Like,
Yeah, because you put our chest out. Okay, so for our real piece, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the real piece.
Why is your voice shaky, though?
Vibrato.
Okay, so let him be a man. Mm. Even though we don't have actual pictures of men, but you won't understand.
What?
With the way things are going, in due time, we might just mistake a goat for a man.
What's it with you?
That, goat? I mean, an actual goat.
This is wrong.
Wow. Well, it is a fact that most the prompter lady decided to laugh too. Well, it is a fact that most parents spend half the time training women to be good cooks, great in bed, cleaners, etc. Lesser time is spent on the actual mental development of the boy.
I need to snap to that.
But why are we still looking at goats, though?
I don't know. Where are the men now?
Because sometimes you actually think they are goats. So it's okay for the goats to roll up.
That's a man without a brain.
So giving your son or your husband or friend the car keys when he needs it, wiring money to his account at his every call, putting food on the table, handling his laundry, etc. wouldn't exactly enable him to realize that life is tough. And of course, as your son, he deserves the good things of life, which you can give him for now. What happens when he has to make actual decisions? But the main question is, to what extent are we allowed to spoil our male children?
You know, I've noticed mothers and like their last boys, and God help you if that last boy is the last born, they have this bond. It's like they're like super soft, or if it's an only boy,
yeah.
There's this special bond they have, and it's kind of scary. Because when they get older, I get scared, like, will they be able to adjust and stuff?
I remember there was a time, I think we're going or we're coming back, or something, anyways, this was when we're still a bit, not so young, but old enough. Then we told my brother to boil yam, because I think we were on our way home or something. He was the only one at home. So he was supposed to, just to boil yam. That's how we came up. We said, Alpha, you said he didn't boil the yam. My brother was like, we should leave him. He's a, so he's a boy. Yeah. You and my staff, Hannah, my staff, we talked to her. What is that supposed to mean? So on his own, he cannot go boil yam if he moves into his own house. We told him that's nonsense. We told him, enter that kitchen. I slice the yam, we'll teach you. And he bought that yam.
And your mom
day.
Allowed, trust me, my last
yes.
born. And funny enough, my the last born in my house happened to be the most, he's the nicest, calm, everything, but there are just certain things.
An Amakulo that is nice.
Yes, very calm, you need to see him. He's like, him, my elder brother, and my father on a different plane. They are not from us, actually. But the issue I have with him, and I tell him, is that I don't think he's streetwise. Because he's been spoiled so much, we're not allowed to do certain things. Because my mom will go, I know, even at his age, my mom goes, oh, please leave him, he's my baby. So he's not street sharp.
How
he's,
old is he?
He's about maybe 24. No, not 24, 22.
He's still the baby.
About, yeah, and he's still a baby. In fact, it's so bad that we call him Toe Boy.
At 24.
My cousin had one time, I went, what? I do it too. I call him Toe Boy.
Tell me his full name so that in case one of my nephews or nieces come and says I met a nice.
But he's very nice. He's very he's very charming. But
do you know what position are you in your family?
I'm the fifth.
Oh, okay.
Out of 10.
No, out of 8.
So it's just Valerie, Yinka, and him.
That I'm older than
Yeah, okay, all right.
So you're like a baby
too.
Bad.
Yeah, I'm almost a baby. Yeah.
But this one.
So, but I feel that there are some things you need to teach, especially doing their own laundry, cooking, and then the tough love that we spoke about, was it yesterday?
Yeah,
there are just some times that they need to leave the house and do something. Not every time they come to ask you for money, you give them. I have the weakness. If my brother should say, give me money now, I'll give him regardless of whether I gave him money yesterday. Oh, bring me back to
which one, Yinka?
Yinka.
I know.
Proceed.
No, but I think you're very correct in terms of the fact that women I've seen in many cases where it is obvious discrimination between the boy and the girl, particularly, like you said, the younger boy, you know, in Africa and also in particular, because they see the boy as, you know, oh, don't let him do this, the girls can do that. Do you know, because of that, my auntie said that she did not want to have any girl because she wanted to have only boys so that she would make them do all the housework that she, you know, they were told in when they were younger that boys weren't meant to do. So I think in Africa, we should, like Titi said, they need to know how to do these things. I don't think cooking is a special thing, like, oh, it should be gender-based, because it is a skill for life.
If you want to eat, learn how to cook.
But our ancient fathers were gatherers. We were the
gatherers, and they were the hunters. And wearing loincloths.
No, but aside from cave, like my dad never go into the kitchen when he was
I'm not saying they should go into the kitchen. I'm saying that they should know how to cook.
But not the basic stuff.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yes. Especially when you move into your own house, it helps you because all these straight girls, they're going to cook for you.
Mine is just special. When you get to your home, if your arrangement with your wife is that she's the one who cooks, fine. But you should have the skill so that you're not stranded.
And help out somehow.
White rice and stew.
Yeah.
Be able to cook it for yourself.
Also, Gary.
Some cannot even boil egg properly. The egg will explode.
But the thing is, really, like, there are people that are really taking this stuff so far about the husband helping out in the kitchen. You know, I'm not big on that either.
I don't mind caring about that.
If you want to help, if you don't want to help.
But I think you should relieve your wife. I mean, if clearly she's tired, she's carrying your child and all
but
that.
But I wouldn't
help
impose my views.
I believe, look,
if you don't want
to help me cook, then at least then you order dinner for us.
But do other stuff. If you're not cooking clean or something, that's my own. But I don't have to say, oh, come and help me when I'm cooking rice, be cutting the onion or something. No.
No, if you want to help.
No, it's not by force. I think it'll be. Do you know, in my home, I know this is ideal, but I wouldn't want to have to force him to do certain things. I want him to be considerate so he sees that my wife comes back home, she's tired. The little, like, you know, let me just, I want to help her out, so that's why I'm doing it. Not because.
Ever.
You know,
do we help them, like, with the generator?
I will
do you help them
it.
With the garage?
I will
I'm saying he knows his territory and we should know ours too.
Yeah. Yeah, but that's what people say. But me, I think, except he wants to help Innocent in the kitchen, that's the chef. Then it's fine.
Why does it have to be Innocent?
Yeah, the Innocent ones are the demonic ones.
The old man.
But you know, Glory actually raised a very good point because I have a friend that is married that does all the cooking, but her husband does, when there's no fuel, he goes to get it, he handles the gen, he handles all the housing thing. Yeah. He's very, and those are the things that she cannot do. All she does is come home, cook and clean. I don't think that's so bad.
No, but I like that. That's the vision of labor. You know your lane. Stay on your lane. Yeah. I don't think it's like, oh, because I also agree that there should be, you shouldn't be a struggle for everything must be equal. Yeah. It doesn't even make sense.
No.
Even if you're doing something, you say, oh, you handle this and I'll do this. It makes work easier. That's the vision of labor. That makes sense.
And if you want to help out occasionally somebody else's duties, you can. It's not you know, whatever. Okay, so cool. Let us know what you think, though. How much are we allowed to spoil our male children? Hit us up on Twitter and Facebook. I always want to say Instagram. I think it's high time we have an Instagram.
Yeah,
I
don't care.
Because I keep wanting to say Instagram. Okay, so hit us up on Twitter.
Instagram, Cool TV Nigeria.
Why don't you continue?
Oh, okay. Hit us up on Facebook and Twitter because she had to give it over to me. You know, like my brain is...
Because she really knows it, that's why.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool TV, the blog, that's Facebook, Twitter as well. Cool TV, the blog. Email blog@cooltv.cool. We're on YouTube, Cool TV the blog.
Instagram,
Cool
Instagram,
TV
Instagram.
Nigeria. Cool TV, no, I'm Cool TV the blog.
Wow.
No, we're Cool TV the blog.
No, darling,
if you
cool
search.
TV Nigeria.
If you search.
Oh, okay.
But we are under Cool TV Nigeria.
Yeah, but search for Cool TV the blog.
Well, but if you go on YouTube and search the blog, we will pop up because I've done that.
Yeah.
And
Final
then
word.
We're popping up.